10 years ago, when we got together between MIT and the University of Southampton, we really had the goal to make the web an object of study. A lot of us had been involved in the development of web technology in various ways and studying public policy issues related to the web, but we hadn't really yet had a formal, organized way of studying the web. And we wanted to do two things. First of all, we wanted to understand how to evolve the web so that it would meet new needs. And secondly, we wanted to be able to look at the web as a large and complex system. When I'll never forget when I was talking with a colleague of mine who's a law professor and studies these issues about web science. I tried to explain to him what we were doing, and he said, "Oh, you mean you want to include the people in the web?" And I said, "Yeah, that's right. We want to understand how the web works, including the people in it, because that's really the only way to understand the web." I think that over the last 10 years, it's been very exciting to see that we've been able to train a whole group of computer scientists and social scientists, legal scholars, others who've really learned how to look at the web as a system, as a unique phenomenon. And I think we've learned a lot about privacy, we've learned a lot about security, we've learned a lot about the behavior of groups of people on the web. So I think we've had a very exciting first decade of web science.